Hello dear students, welcome to a new video. In this video, we'll start with new topics.
In our previous class, we have learned about catalyst, promoter and poison. So in today's class, we'll see types of catalyst. There are two types of catalyst. The first one is homogeneous catalyst and the second one is heterogeneous catalyst. Homo means same, hetero means different. Let us see the definition for homogeneous catalyst. When the reactant products and the catalyst are in the same phase, liquid or gas, the process is said to be homogeneous catalyst. Now here, phases means we have three phases, solid, liquid and gas. So here the two phases will be liquid or gas. That means when we talk about a reaction, if the reactant, the catalyst and the product is in the same phase, you can see here gas, gas, gas. So this will be an example of homogeneous catalyst. Here also you can see liquid, liquid, aqueous, aqueous, and even this is in liquid. Now liquid and aqueous, they are almost same. Liquid, you already know it will be water. And what about aqueous? Aqueous means water where we mix our solute. So when we mix solute in water, it becomes an aqueous solution. So we can say that all are in this liquid or same phase. So here also, aqueous, liquid, all are in this aqueous liquid phase only. So homogeneous catalyst means that all the reactant catalyst and our product will be in single phase. In homogeneous catalyst, we have only two phase, that is liquid and gas. Now let us see about heterogeneous catalyst. Here it is clearly written that the catalytic process in which the reactant and the catalyst are in different phases is known as heterogeneous catalyst. That means here we are going to have different state of reactant and the catalyst. For example, you can see here this reaction, the reactant and the product are gases, but the catalyst is solid. So whenever we have different states in a reaction, you have to know that it is a heterogeneous catalytic process. Once again, a homogeneous catalysis process will be one in which the reactant product and the catalyst are all in same phase, whereas heterogeneous catalysis process will be the one in which the reactant and the catalyst will be in different phases. On page 131, Haber's process, Ostwald process, these all come under heterogeneous catalysis process. So Haber process is basically the manufacture of ammonia, and Ostwald process is the manufacture of nitric acid, which we will discuss in detail later. Now let us see the adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalysis. Under this, we will basically be studying about the mechanism of heterogeneous catalysis. However, there is an old theory associated with it known as the adsorption theory of catalysis, where the reactant is in gaseous state or in solutions which are adsorbed on the surface of the solid catalyst. The surface will basically be solid and the reactant which will come and sit on the surface will basically be gas or in solution state. Here it is clearly mentioned that if the concentration of the reactant on the surface increases, the rate of the reaction will also increase. And we have studied that it is an exothermic process. As our physisorption and chemisorption both are exothermic process, so the heat released during this process is used for enhancing the rate of the reaction. So I was basically reading whatever is given in this paragraph. It is very easy. If you go through, you will easily understand. However, now the modern theory, the modern adsorption theory is basically the combination of intermediate compound formation and also the old adsorption theory. So in the old adsorption theory, what was happening? We were discussing only about the adsorption process. But in this modern, we are going to even study about the formation of an intermediate compound along with the combination of the old adsorption theory. Now let us see the mechanism involved in this catalytic process. There are five steps involved in it. The first one is diffusion of reactant to the surface of the catalyst. Now what is diffusion? We understand that diffusion means breaking down. So in the first step, what is happening? Our reactant is going to diffuse. For example, if we have hydrogen molecule here, In our first step, what will happen? This hydrogen molecule is going to break down as their respective atoms. And the reactant molecule which got diffused will now be adsorbed on the surface of the catalyst. So we had our molecules getting diffused. So now this will get adsorbed on the surface. Adsorbed, AD. Now, what will happen? After it gets adsorbed on the surface, there will be a chemical reaction which will be occurring here, resulting in the formation of a product. Now, this will combine and they are going to give you a product. Now, this is the intermediate product form after which desorption will occur. Now, what is desorption? Desorption is basically removal of whatever has been adsorbed on the surface. That means it will be removed. It will be removed so that the surface becomes available once again for more reaction to occur. So it will get removed. It is also explained here, diffusion of reaction product away from the catalyst surface. That means what will happen, desorption will occur and this whatever has been adsorbed on the surface will be removed so that this area become available for more reaction to occur. So this is what happens in the mechanism of your heterogeneous catalysis process. Now let us try to understand the mechanism better. So in the first step, what happened? Diffusion happened. So initially we had the catalyst surface and we had the reacting molecules. So what happened? So this reacting molecule will get diffused, will break down and then come as individual molecules and sit on the surface of the catalyst. Now what will happen? Adsorption will occur. After adsorption occur, they will give you an intermediate product. Now you can see they have formed a product by joining with each other. Now after they form an intermediate product, what will happen? Again, desorption will occur. That means again, they will be removed from the surface of the catalyst. Again, get individual products. Now here, we see that everything that happened to the reacting molecules. They got diffused, they joined, they became the product. We observe that nothing has happened to the surface of the catalyst. Now, this very process tells us, or this theory helps us to understand why catalysts are not consumed in the reaction. They just help in the reaction, but that they are not consumed. If you check page 131, last line, you will see that it is clearly written, this theory explains why the catalysts remain unchanged in mass and chemical composition at the end of the reaction, and is effective even in small quantity. It, however, does not explain the action of catalytic promoter and catalytic poison. Now, from these lines, we understood that, as I already told you, that the catalysts are not consuming the reaction. They just help in the process of the reaction, initiate or help in increasing the rate of the reaction. Now, here, it is also saying that now when we were studying about this process, there is nowhere mention about the catalytic promoter and poison. So it does not give any information regarding that. We will stop here for this class. If you have any doubt, please feel free to approach. In the next class, we'll start with new topic. Till then, take care. Great hours ahead.